Health Bus over here at Health Bus Rockford Chiropractic Clinic, and recently we did a talk about chia seed pudding, and I wanted to show you how really easy it is to make chia seed pudding. What I have here is 1 cup of almond milk. Now you can use coconut milk or something else instead. I just like almond milk. I try to use dairy free. I have 1/3 cup of chia seeds, black chia seeds. Black or white doesn't make a difference. Then a little bit of vanilla. That's all it is. So this is something my kids and I do a lot. We're just going to dump the 1/3 cup of chia seeds into 1 cup of almond milk. There we go. I'm going to stir that up real nice. Spread those out. Now the consistency of this is it'll turn into like a tapioca-like pudding. This is a superfood, the chia seeds. If you look them up online, you'll see all kinds of great health benefits. And that's all it is. Now I'm just going to put a little shot of vanilla in there just for a little extra flavor for now. About a teaspoon. There we go. Give it one more good stirring here. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this in the fridge. Now usually what I do at home is I make it up at night, and I had this for my breakfast in the morning. So we're going to put it in the fridge now and let it sit for about 6-7 hours, and we'll be back to show you how it comes out. All right, so it's now the end of the day here at the clinic, and I came down to check the chia seed pudding. You can see it looks a lot like a tapioca-like pudding. See right here, we're going to let it sit for about 8 hours. It's real thick. The chia seeds have swollen up, and it basically has like I said, a pudding like texture to it to make sure it's done. Now what we did halfway through, we came down and stirred up again. So sometimes that's a good idea if you can. Obviously if you put it in for the fridge overnight, that's not really a choice. But we gave it one more good shake and it came out pretty good. And very good. Thank you.